garbage. New bag, got lights on it. Gotta throw the other one away. Old relationships. Old bag, gotta go. See this shit? Garbage.
So, I asked her, how and when did Nicki Minaj steal him from you? She told me that it all started when Nicki Minaj promoted that she was doing this turkey giveaway. Remember, you guys, she took to her Instagram and Nicki Minaj posted November 20th that tomorrow she was doing a turkey drive, okay? So listen, y'all, this turkey giveaway is when everything went sour between Redbone and Kenny, because Kenny really wanted to go to the turkey giveaway. Redbone said that they argued about it. She was like, you better not go. Because keep in mind, you guys, he has told her that in the past, he slept with Nicki Minaj. So why in God's name would she want her man to go to a turkey giveaway to see his ex boo? I'm just saying. But anyways, Redbone told me that Kenneth told her the only reason he wants to go to the turkey giveaway is because he heard Nicki Minaj allegedly was gonna be giving out record deals. And there's a rapper in their area named Lou. So he was really just going for Lou, so Lou could get a record deal, I guess. But Redbone didn't care. She did not want her man going over there looking thirsty, trying to get a record deal from his ex-boo. So she didn't want him to go. So she explained to me that Nicki Minaj was in New York. She did the turkey drive and Kenneth wanted to go so bad. So let's look at the timeline, you guys. Nicki Minaj promoted her turkey giveaway on Tuesday, November 20th. She did the turkey drive on Wednesday, November 21st. And then Thanksgiving was Thursday, November 22nd. Now Redbone said that they argued. He didn't come home until Friday night, Friday the 23rd at nighttime. And then he left early Saturday, November 24th in the morning. She said they were arguing and he didn't answer her phone calls no more. And then the very next day is when she saw Nicki Minaj post a picture of her and Kenneth Zoo together, Sunday, November 25th. And she said she was pissed. She said she commented on Nicki Minaj's post saying, so this is why Kenny is not answering. And she says that Nicki Minaj actually deleted that comment. But a fan got a screenshot of it and sent it to Redbone. Redbone sent it to me, and that's what I'm showing you right here. So it's looking like Nicki Minaj was very aware that he had a girlfriend for her to delete that comment. I'm just saying. So listen, y'all, Redbone's woman intuition was right. She knew good and well that her man did not need to go to no turkey giveaway to see his ex-boo, because what she suspected ended up happening. Nicki Minaj and Kenneth Zoo rekindled their love and now they booze again. Just a mess. So this is what she means by Nicki Minaj stole my man. Now, disclaimer, no disrespect to Redbone. I don't feel like Nicki Minaj stole him. I feel like he left her.
Who are some of the rappers that inspired you to be the rapper you are today? Like, whose bars do you feel the most?
I love Cardi B, Lil Kim, Foxy, Trina. Nah, that's about it.
See, this is where I'm supposed to be messy.
Go ahead, be messy.
There's somebody off that list. Is there a reason why you left said woman off said list?
Who are you talking about? Okay, so
this is how we're going to go? This is how we're going
to go. I don't know what you're talking about.
A long time ago, a long time ago.
Yeah.
I used to host at strip clubs and stuff. So this is where I know Miss Noe, right?
Yeah.
I got a DM one day and she said, tell woman who won't really be named to stop stealing men. I said, excuse me? What do you mean? So she was like, you want to finish the story?
I forgot what I did just say.
So go ahead. So you and her.
I was upset, you know. Somebody stole my man, you know.
How is it
but
stole?
Right now, I'm just I'm happy. Everything, life has been much better since she stole the man, you know.
So how do? Stole is such a strong word, though.
Yeah.
So he was fully.
It's mine.
Yours.
He's mine. But yeah, he was mine.
And just one day, gone.
Gone. I DM'd her. She read it. She seen it. She didn't say nothing back. I left a comment on her page. Like, oh, this is why you're not answering the phone.
Oh, shit. And nothing.
Nothing. She didn't say nothing. I heard from him.
And what he said?
I don't know what the fuck y'all thought, man.
He pulls up in the Cullinan. It's the whip for me.
Going straight to the top.
Let's get into... let's get into a relationship, right? Like, say, like, I boom. It was, I'm gonna brush by this real quick. You was in a public relationship, whatever, blah, blah, blah. What do you have to say about the people that say that you was a jealous ex? Tell the people that the position that you played in that situation and how you've moved on.
The people that saying I'm a jealous ex? It's not, I don't know why they keep saying I'm jealous and bitter. If someone asks me a question, I'm going to answer. You understand? Like, it's not like I can't get nobody. I could get anybody. Like, my DMs is all millionaires. You know, he's not the only one that could get a millionaire. You understand? Like, my little boo, whatever, he got more money than his millionaire and all the millionaires out there. Like, no.
Okay.
But was there ever a time, like, honestly, was there a time where, like, not say you were bitter, but was there a time, like, yo, you were affected, like, you were hurt?
Hell yeah, I was affected. Okay. I mean, like, a person you was living with, like, seeing every day and talking to every day, and then all of a sudden they not answering the phone, and then I'm thinking something happened to the nigga. You should see my text message. I'm like, yo, are you okay? Like, should I call the cops? Like, what the fuck is going on? Because we did have an argument, but...
You like, it wasn't that deep.
Nah, it wasn't that deep. Because last thing he said was, give me some time. I'm going to call you back. Let me calm down. Mm-hmm. Never called me back. I was texting, calling. No, nothing. Then you see them on the... On Instagram, hugs out with somebody. I'm like, what the fuck is this? So I left a comment and shit.
Sometimes when a person goes through a situation like that, they grow in life.
Yes, it definitely helped me.
I mean,
so you can you really mess with a man that's broke?
Nah, I've been there. Done that.
Boom! Little bit of lime. Hold on. Lime your arm. Lime your arm. Lime you. Lime you.
I care what you
lime want. Lime you. Lime you. You mean you can't do that? Huh?
I cannot do that.
Give everybody the opportunity.
Listen, no.
Scott Martin. Boom!
No. I'm on fire. Yo, what the fuck? This shit gets splashed over here.
Yeah, we listening.
No. I date somebody. When they was broke, I helped them out.
Mm-hmm.
They leave me for a millionaire.
Oh, please.
They leave me for a millionaire.
Please, I don't know
so
about
that. It's like I can't even do that no more. So it's like now everybody is like...
Listen, I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know if that's true or not. But what I would tell you is that...
I was dating somebody while they was broke. I'm not like that. But now it's like I can't do it no more. I wash my hands with...
Redbone was the girlfriend after your best friend.
After my best friend, she was somebody that they were having entanglements. From my understanding, it was never something that he came out and said. He always denied the girl because she would harass my best. She would harass like my best friend.
Girlfriend after your best friend.
After my best friend, she was somebody that they were having entanglements. It was never something that he came out and said. He always denied the girl because she would harass my best. She would harass like my best friend. Like this life with Nikki, because he did have to get his innocence taken away from him. Because at that point, me and my best friend were going at it so much with this. Did my baby father do this? Or when we get into an argument with each other over little stuff, it was something that came up. So it was like, okay, I need to get down to the bottom of it. We put Jennifer on three-way. Me and the baby mother, we put Jennifer on three-way. She even had no idea. I told her it was, and then I called her again with a friend that I told her was a lawyer friend of mine. Just to hear her. To hear her story out, like really giving her a chance, because I swore to my best friend, like, I don't know, like, I don't know, I believe my cousin. Because you want to believe your cousin, you want to believe the person from your household, you want to be supportive.
Right.
When this girl said to me that second time that I allowed her to say that story, and she said, I mean, yeah, because I already was going on into it in the house, and this happened, and it was just... When I went to him, I was just so upset that he would treat me like that, already knowing what I've been through.
But go ahead, I'm sorry, go ahead.
I don't know, I'm just a good supporter. Mm-hmm. I was with someone before, they got, like, you know, I hate talking about stuff like this, but, you know, because people think I'm hating or I'm still, mad about something, but not
holding on to things.
Yeah, but you ask, so I'm gonna answer. They had like a money situation. They got broke, and I said, "Don't worry." They literally they cried to me, like real tears, like. Stop it! Why are you looking at me?
No, go ahead. I'm involved.
So he was crying. He was crying. So you know, I'm his girl. So. If I got it, I said, you know what? Don't worry about it. He made up a whole story talking about somebody robbed his grandmother house and all this extra shit. So I said, don't worry about this. I got this. I went, got $10,000. It was my singles. Singles from the club. He walked out with my $10,000. I said, yo, do something with this. If you're a man, if you're a street man, you're going to... Do what you do. Flip it, double it. Uh-huh. And that's what I did.
Wow.
One question for you before you get out of here. What are you doing to stay corona-free right now?
Oh, time, but have you talked to Redbone? Remember, she was viciously beat up.
That was another thing. Like, you know, people exclude her.
To be one of Nicki Minaj and Kenneth Petty's affiliates. Sue is claiming, or the alleged rape victim is claiming, that Ganks reached out to her sometime this year to offer her hush money, try to bribe her, give her $20,000 to stop speaking on the situation. Then they relayed a message to the alleged rape victim's family members telling them that if Sue does not take the hush money, then they're going to use that same money to put a hit out on Sue.
It looks like talking to this YouTuber has worked. The marshals are investigating. There is an investigation going on. This is a high priority case for them, and they have found evidence. I cannot say much more.
She said, "Now they're gonna say that the Daily Beast was lying about the high priority case, but they could possibly say that because I said I don't have a case against them. The U.S. Marshals is not me. I'm not the U.S. Marshals. You know what I'm saying? Like I have no control over what they decide to do.
Right.
But as of right now, that I don't know anything about anything more than." You know what I'm saying? Then you guys know. We'll be right back.
in any room that I stand in. I am the standout, you just my stand-in. These bitches copy my homework, that's what they hand in. That's why I'm private like the airports I land in. Life is a beach house, don't let the sand in. I ball in any arena, go let the fans in. I should go cop a New Jersey, that's where the Camden. These bitches time TikTokin', better stick to dancing. I DNG the wallet, my money tall and brolic. Big ass backyards, just so Papa Bear could frolic. One margarita pizza with Parmesan and garlic. These bitches thirsty, I can see why they alcoholics. Ain't gotta ever talk about it when you aren't about it. Just bought a new car, not to drive it, but to walk around it. Just call me Nicki, cop the blicky, the Minaj is silent. Brand new vanilla Maserati, I've been Haagen-Dazsing. He call me solid, even though I'm dripping water diet. Big booty sticking out, my Daisy Dukes will cause a riot. These bitches still my sons, who could ever deny it? My packs get different, who could ever supply it? No one bitch could be my op, that shit offends me. It's corporate giants and machines that went against me. I watched bitches, man, they couldn't even rinse me. She said she hot, I said, well, bitch, come and convince me. Ain't no seeing green, but I'm seeing green. Even with them floor seats, they couldn't see the team. The K-I-N-G, the GOAT, plus me, the queen. I send shots, send them back, or flee the scene.
You know, one of the perils of making money is you can afford to be dramatic. Y'all some drama queens, for real. It's all good, though. You now tune into the biggest ever. YMCMB, Tunchi Lee, Young Angel, Young Lion, man. Y'all boys get on a track with Onika Mirage and y'all still dying, man. What's up?
Hey, loves. I'm not going to hold y'all any longer, so let's get into this mess. Look, I'm not on Kenneth's side because what he did to Redbone was straight up wrong, but goddamn, it is 3 years now, okay? Now, what my problem with the situation is, you're mad at Nicki and you keep saying, oh, she stole my man. Nobody can steal anybody from you, sweetie. He left. And then, another problem. You got your peoples, and you, these extortion crew that you running with behind the scenes, and you think people don't know, but we know. Thinking that Kenneth and Nicki put a hit out on you because of that text message you sent Nicki. The text message you sent Nicki December 2018. March 2019, you got attacked. And you got people thinking, you know, it's Kenny and Nicki. They sent somebody to do it. And what's so funny about this whole situation is this. She come out and clear up a rumor that makes her look bad when it's her versus them. But then when it's them versus her and they looking bad and it makes her look good, oh, she ain't gonna say nothing. So I'ma say something. You need to tell the truth because I want to talk to the detective. You need to tell the truth. You need to sit up there and tell the truth. Because one, if they sent a hit out on Redbone, she's been talking since November 25th, 2018. Ain't stopped yet. So you gonna keep talking shit and posting shit. And these people sent the hit out on you? Come on now. That's just like Jennifer sitting right there saying, oh, Nicki was harassing me. Nicki was harassing me. Nicki was harassing you the whole year. And you on YouTube crying like, why she didn't say nothing? Why she gonna come and call me a liar? Y'all, are y'all related? Because y'all sound like y'all could be related. Nothing. Redbone, you got your people believing that Kenneth bought you that car on Valentine's Day. How can a broke bum Redbone buy you a car? And then on top of that, you post the car and said you got it yourself on your own. But when you started posting it more and more and people started adding, oh, that's the car Zoo bought her for Valentine's Day in 2019. That's the car. That's the car. Like, you really want people to think that you steal something to him when you nothing. You the type of chick that will post receipts. You don't post receipts. You're doing a Khloe Kardashian. You use quotes to throw shade. Then you playing behind the scenes with Hotshot and them. I mean, come on now. They, every time they tag you, hey sis, and oh, hashtag Nicki Minaj, like every time. And it's so funny to me because she want to stand for Jennifer, right? What about them two women with French Montana? The ones that went viral before you got your ass on that yacht with them. You only standing with Jennifer because it's against the Petties, and you know this shit ain't right, and you know Jennifer is a fucking liar. I believe the baby mom more than I believe her, and the baby mom even don't believe what Kenneth did to her, to Jennifer. So you standing with Jennifer, but yeah, you wanna yacht with somebody who just was getting accused 2 weeks before you got on that yacht with him. But then you want to get on interviews and say, I don't know why people think I'm bitter or I'm hater. You is fucking bitter. You is fucking hater. And you a fucking two-faced. Because I did that right there made me mad, because when you try to play Kenneth and say, oh, I didn't know, I wouldn't date no guy like that. I wouldn't even put it past if Redbone had her hands in the pot with Jennifer. All of a sudden, they following each other and everything. Anything that that make Kenneth Petty and Nikki look bad, they for it. Because they miss Kenneth. I don't know what Kenneth got going on, but honey. So, you want to sit here, right? Say this and don't come out and say that. And then, oh, I have a millionaire. I have millionaires in my inbox. I got a millionaire now that makes more money than his millionaire. No, the fuck you don't. If you got all of that, right, why the fuck you worrying about Kenneth and his millionaire wife all the fucking time? Why are you posting quotes and throwing shots and lying all the fucking time? And what was so funny to me about this whole situation, you want to call Nikki obsessed, but your ass went all the way back to October 2020 to get that picture after Nikki posted her picture for her birthday, and then you want to say obsessed? No, honey, you is. You went all the way back to October 20th, got that Polaroid picture and posted. Are you serious? Then I could recall, oh, you was throwing shade about Nikki being a rapper and stuff like that. And now look at you. You want to be a rapper. Talk about run that shit back. No, run that shit straight to the motherfucking garbage. Another thing. What is there a problem, or what is so funny for a man to want to clean up his credit, get his life in order? See, when you meet a good woman, that's what the fuck you do. Because when he met you, he kept going in and out of jail. What did you do? But dance. Or whatever you call yourself, because you say you a bottle girl, but I don't know, I ain't never seen nobody go bottle girl dressed like that, but okay. What do you do? If it wasn't for fucking Nikki, you wouldn't be known. Nobody didn't know you until you put them text messages out, until you was on Nikki inbox and doing all, nobody didn't know you. So you thank them, because if you go back and look at your pictures compared to now, you thank her. Okay? Then hold on. I'm not mad at the girl. Like, it's just that don't sit up here and act like you just, oh, they did this to me. When you behind the pot, you staring the pot, you let Hotshot and unpost everything. Hotshot has no room to even laugh about a man fixing up his credit when he lives in a fucking hotel. Talk about some, oh, this ain't my crib, I'm quarantined, this ain't my crib, no, and I gotta hurry up and get off of this. No, because the hotel lobby computers, they close at 12 o'clock a.m. You have a certain time. Why y'all think every time he take a picture by the hotel pool, talk about a fucking getaway, bitch, bye. Then, when Armand asked Jennifer on Clubhouse, oh, hey, have you spoken to Redbone? You can hear Nosy Ho said, yes, I spoke to her briefly. We already know they talking, because she let them, allows them to share her shit, just the hashtag. You still want Kenneth, say it. Then you want to get up here, do interviews. You know they're going to ask you about Nikki, so you be excited. You even bring them up when they ain't talking. That guy was talking to her, she was saying, yeah, I used to date a broke person, this and that and that. But when you, hold on. And then you know what? Let's back up the broke person. When you did an interview, right? You were talking to the guy and they were asking you questions. And he was like, yeah, when I was 16 in high school, I was dating older guys. They just picked me up with their nice cars and stuff. And my baby dad, he was buying me expensive gifts and everything else. So Kenneth is a broke bitch, right? A broke bum, not bitch, sorry. A broke bum, right? So you downgraded to a broke bum. Girl, stop. 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 And it's so funny because I go and look at these pictures, throwback pictures of Kenneth. He don't look like a broke bum to me, but since Jennifer and Jennifer is mad and she's still mad, I guess that's how it's gonna go. Then with us. If Kenneth is doing all this stuff that you claim he is doing, or you just throwing shots every time you turn around, and then you allow your crew, the extortion crew, to just put anything out there, where's the receipts? Because you looking like Jennifer. You got dementia now? Because Jennifer trying to act like she got dementia. The only reason Jennifer trying to act like she got dementia is because she trying to drop this case. But it ain't going to happen because you done did too much. I guess she had dementia when she wrote that recant letter in 1994 too. Okay. Now, if Kenneth is doing all this stuff, where are the receipts? You don't post no receipts. And you're the type of chick that's going to post receipts. You post a text message. Where's the other ones? Let them people live. They ain't worrying about you. She ain't rapping about you. She ain't saying anything about you. It's you. Every time she do something, here you come. You like Jennifer. It's like, damn. Y'all just sit back and say, wait till Nikki posts. And then you got something to say. I could not believe you gonna say obsessed when you went all the way back to October 20th, 2020. Got that picture and posted it. After Nikki posts hers. I can't believe that. But then you want to get on and everybody's saying, I don't know why people saying I'm bitter and stuff like that. But look at the shit you're doing. Then you running with the surviving the petty. I can't believe that. You want to stand with Jennifer, but then stand with them two ladies with French Montana. Girl, bye. Go sit down and eat a steak or something because it's not working. And you so happy. You're happy. You got a house, but you still find a way to look miserable by harassing Kenneth and Nikki by posting shit. They don't post about you. Let these people be happy. Then you want to put out there, oh yeah, he got mad because he thought I was talking to his friend. Give me his number. Post the number. Can you post the call log? I don't want to see a number saved. Post the call log, okay? Ugh. Telling you, these females nowadays, I mean, and it just makes me so mad. The whole thing just makes me so mad because at the end of the day, you got real victims and they playing in these victim fucking faces. That's my whole problem. I don't give a fuck about anything. You got real victims out here going through it. I know a real victim who didn't make it. I know a real victim who didn't make it and the daughter didn't make it neither. But I ain't going to talk about that because I'm not ready to talk about that. But I will talk about it soon. And you got these bitches like them playing around. And it's not funny. It broke my heart the other day to see this lady comment and says, Jennifer is making us look real bad. Us real rape victims. It's sad. It's sad. Because you want people that think they getting money. So they want to push this narrative. Now they know shit about to hit the fan. Now everybody, I don't remember that. My memory is going to fade. No, call the marshals. The one that called you and told you that it was an investigation going on. Call them. Let them know. Take Redbone with you. That's all I got to say. At the end of the day, leave them alone. They living their life. They married. They doing what they doing. They raising their kids. Kenneth loved Nikki. And Nikki loved Kenneth. And then, on top of that, Kenneth knew Onika before Nicki Minaj. He's no stranger. What name he got tattooed on his neck? My point exactly. Have a good day. Bye.
I was like, why are you so obsessed with me?